doing wrong. Then my living shall not be in vain. If I can help somebody as I travel along, if I can help somebody with words or song, if I can keep somebody from doing wrong, then my living shall not be in vain, in vain, in vain, in vain, in vain, in vain, in vain.
Right where you are. Father God, we just thank you for this moment, Lord. I personally thank you for this moment, God. To stand before your people, Father God, I thank you, Father, for choosing me. Sometimes when I have self-doubt, you push me right on back out there, God. And I thank you, Jesus. Now, Lord, I ask that you remove everything that's not like you right now, God, and fill me with your word and your word only, God. Lord, I ask that you open the ears and the hearts of your people, God, to receive the word that you have given me on this morning, Father God. Lord, I ask that the people do not leave the same way that they came, in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, I want to thank you again for the shepherd of this house, Father God. Lord, thank you. Lord, thank you for giving him everything that you're giving, Father God, because he knows exactly what to say, when to say, and how to say it, God. And Lord, I thank you for his obedience on not moving until you tell him to move, Father God. And Lord, I thank you for his wife. I thank you for our first lady, Latifa Reed, Father God, for being right there with him, Father God, standing right there behind him, Father God, and the family, Lord. And I thank you for every elder, every preacher, every minister, every deacon, every usher, every member of Covenant House Word of Faith Ministries, Father God, the people that you call to do your will, Father God. And Lord, I thank you for every visitor that's here on today, God. None of me and all of you, God. None of me and all of you, God. And Lord, I thank you. I thank you for my helpmate, God. Continue to bless me, God. Continue to do what you do, God, because nobody can do it but you, God. In your son Jesus' name, let your word go forth like never before, God. Never before, God, out of my mouth. In Jesus' name, I pray on this morning. Amen, 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 and amen. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen again.
Amen.
I want to move right along. You all know I love you. That's, he's already said it. I've said it in my prayers. I just thank God for being a member of Covenant House Word of Faith Ministry.
Amen.
And it's crazy that, or ironic that, exactly 6 months ago I stood here. 6 months ago. God knows when to move. He knows what to do and he knows how to do it. If you will go with me in your Bible, this is twofold. This is a twofold message. The first will be only for your hearing. And I want you to write it down and go back and meditate on it. And the second part, that's where the word is going to come from. So if you will, turn with me in your Bible to Luke chapter 6, 27 through the 36th verse. And as you're looking for Luke chapter 6, 27 through the 36th verse, I always read about the author of the book. And Luke, he was unique in that Luke never got an opportunity to meet Jesus, but he still chose to follow him. And he wrote everything. He wrote his book in the gospel, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Luke book was the longest book. But he never got an opportunity to really touch Jesus. But he saw him, and he saw his actions. I want you to keep that word in your mind on today. Actions. Actions. Say it with me. Say actions. Because they speak louder than words. Amen. So with that being said, if you're there, say amen. And you don't have to stand because it's pretty long. But just read with me in your heart and let it meditate. And it reads, but I say to you who hear, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. That's hard to do, y'all.
Amen.
Bless those who curse you. for those who spitefully use you. These are Jesus' words. To him who strikes you on the one cheek, offer the other also. And from him who takes away your cloak, do not withhold your tunic either. Give to everyone who asks of you. And from him who takes away your goods, do not ask for them back. And just as you want men to do to you, you also do to them likewise. But if you love those, this is good, y'all, listen to this. But if you only love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who want to do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same thing. And if you lend to those from whom you hope to receive back, what credit is that to you? For even sinners lend to sinners and want to receive as much back. But he said, love your enemies, do good, and lend, hoping for nothing in return. And your reward will be great, and you will be the sons of the Most High. For he is kind. Oh, this is my favorite. For God himself is kind to the unthankful and the evil. Therefore, he said, be merciful, just as your Father is merciful to you.
Amen.
With that being said, y'all, I want you to go home really for real and read that and meditate on it. Because a lot of people are not getting where they need to be because they're holding things. And they're picking out who they want to serve or who they want to be friends with and who they want to love. Jesus didn't do that, because if he did, a lot of us would have been left out. So I want you to think about those things as you go forward. Go home and let that marinate in your spirit. I love to say that because it means it soaks in your spirit. You know, oftentimes we say, I love her, but child, she. No, it's no but child, she. You got to love him in spite of. Jesus is gone. He left us to be his disciples. We are supposed to live like he lived when he was here. We're supposed to go forth like he went forth when he was here. Now, we got to get rid of all of that. You have to love him. I know all the time I get criticized for, you're a fool. She just did that to you, or he just did that to you, and you still talking to him. But what if Jesus stopped talking to me when I did things that I wasn't supposed to do? You have to consider yourself in everything that you go through. Now sometimes we get mad, we gotta let that thing about, look, I can't talk to you right now. I just can't talk right now. But you gotta go and get it right. Because you always have to say, What if Jesus did me like that? Where would I be? So keep that in your spirit and move right along to where the words gonna come from. And it's all gonna make sense. What's the word for today?
Action.
Is that right now?
Action.
Okay, move right along. So we're moving to Luke now. Still in Luke. Chapter 6, verses 43 through 45. Y'all with me? Say amen. Okay, all right. Y'all with me? And it reads, for a good tree does not bear bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. For men do not gather figs from thorns, nor do they gather grapes from bramble bush. A good man out of the good treasures of his heart brings forth good fruit. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil fruit. But no matter how you come, it says, for out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth will speak. You will be able to tell after why. All right, you all may be seated. Now, with that being said, we're talking about fruit. Y'all stay with me now. And I know you're not a real fruit, but fruit, when you think about fruit, fruit is produce.
Yes.
And if you produce something, that means you can reproduce. Uh-huh. And I went on further to read about fruit, and it said, fruit has seeds in it. Uh-huh. I said, ooh. Uh-huh. So seeds, you got to dig them out of your plant, the seeds you watch them grow. Uh-huh. So if you're the right fruit and you're the good fruit, and you came from the good place, you should have some seeds in it. Uh-huh. And you should be sprinkling those seeds in it. I said sprinkling, I know it's sprinkling, but stay with me. I said sprinkling them all over so that other fruits can be reproduced. Now, if you don't have anything in you to sprinkle, nothing can reproduce. Now, I'm a visual person. Y'all stay with me. What are pictures on that? Now, sometimes, we can look at people and say, that's a good person right there. Look, they good. They got the title. They dressed up. They fixed up. Oh, that's a good person. I know. Well, I saw them. They good. Now I'm gonna ask you something now, okay? You just raise your hand. I know it seems like I'm teaching, but this is how you gave it to me.
No, no.
Okay? Now, this morning, we're gonna be some apples.
Yeah.
I like apples.
Yeah.
Now, I know y'all cut open, they got seeds. I don't eat the seeds, but I like the apples.
Yeah,
all right. Okay, now, picture number one.
Uh-huh.
If you can see it, it looks like a pretty apple, right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh, can y'all see it?
Yeah.
That's a good apple. Now, let me ask you something. I'm looking at it. Is that a real apple or is it a fake apple?
It's fake.
It's fake? The picture, let me see, is it a picture of a real apple or is it a picture of a fake apple?
Okay,
it look like it's fake. Okay, all right. Well, what about these apples right here? Cause some of them like it's a, it's hard to tell, huh? Huh? Say what, now, come on now, what does it look like? Okay, so Dr. Mary, where you going here? I'm gonna make my point in just a few. Just cause it looked like an apple, this was fake. It looked good, doesn't it? Still sticking out, all painted good. Just because it looked like a real apple doesn't mean it's a real apple. Because if I slice this one open, I know it's plastic. It's going to be empty, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to equate the plastic apples with being fake and man-made. Okay?
Yeah.
Now, when you, okay, look, equate the real apples to being real and produce. Because they got seeds in it. When I slice it open, I got some seeds in it, okay? So that means that it can reproduce if I take those seeds out and plant them, right? Y'all with me? So the text on today, and I'm not gonna be long. Y'all know from all those stuff. The question is, you know, you go to the grocery store. Have y'all ever went to the grocery store and they said, paper or plastic, ma'am? Would you like paper or plastic? And guess what? You have a choice, right? Some of y'all like plastic, some of y'all like paper, and you chose which one you wanted, right? Well, the Lord is asking you today, are you produce or plastic? Okay? And it's your decision. Not judging. Are you produce or are you plastic? Because you can't fool the Lord. He knows what seeds are there. Okay? But he sent you down on this earth. If you are still breathing, if air is pumping through your lungs, then you're here for a reason. And you choose one. Are you plastic or are you produce? Now, with that being said, when you're produce, you don't have to walk around saying, I'm a real apple, I have seeds in me, oh watch me, put me open to my seeds. If you're a real apple, as you go along, the seeds should be sprinkled, and people should see the other fruits growing up. People should see the good that flows out of you, because it's talking about your heart, it's going to come from your heart. What's in your heart, you're going to be vigilant speak. Now the man-made apple, the plastic apple, they're created in the shop. Yeah. Now you got some people that they don't like you unless they can mold you like they want you. They don't like you unless your steel is turned like their steel is turned. And if they can't take that paintbrush and paint you how they want you to be painted, then they don't want to fool with you. Okay? So it is some things coming from them, but they're not being reproduced. Now I'm asking you on this morning, do you have a paintbrush or do you have seeds? Are you letting somebody else paint you the wrong way? Because you saw pictures. It's a beautiful picture.
Yeah.
The apple was beautiful.
Yeah.
So you can't walk through and say, oh, that's a good person, that's a good person. He look good, she look good. Oh, and they got a title. Oh, they're doctor this, and they're Miss this, and they're first this, and they're pastor, and they're... You cannot identify them from the outside.
Yeah.
You have to watch what's going on. Remember the key word, action. And so if you are produce, if you are apple, your actions should speak for you. You don't have to say anything. Now that plastic apple on the other end, that plastic apple really can't talk and you just look good. Turn their nose up. I tell you, come on over here, we look good over here. Get in this clip. We ain't got to look like them. They really can't tell. They can't, I don't know what's going on the inside of us. They can't unzip me and see what's going on. But baby, I promise